Harry Edward Nilsson III, who often went by the single name Nilsson, was born June 15, 1941, in Brooklyn, New York. His father abandoned the family when Harry was only 3 years old. As a teenager, Nilsson moved to Los Angeles and landed a job as a computer programmer at a bank. While there, he developed an interest in musical composition and singing.
I worked at a bank in a computer center for 7 years while other guys were out there, playing the clubs and everything. And in the daytime, I'd go hustle tunes at record companies and say, well, if you don't like the tune, maybe you'll like me.
In 1964, he joined Phil Spector's California songwriting stable. In 1966, Nilsson signed with RCA Records, releasing his first LP with the label, Pandemonium Shadow Show, the following year. The album included a song written by John Lennon, You Can't Do That, which made its way to the Beatle himself.
Well, everybody's records influence all the minds, you know, at once. Everything influences everything. Nilsson's my favorite group.
In 1968, both Lennon and Paul McCartney named Nilsson as their favorite American band.
Someone asked, who's your favorite American singer? And John said, Nilsson.
Eventually, Nilsson would befriend all the Beatles and earn a reputation as a hard partier due to his role in John Lennon's infamous Lost Weekend. In 1968, Nilsson released Aerial Ballet, which included his cover of Fred Neil's Everybody's Talking.
Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear a word they're saying.
The track actually didn't crack the top 100 at first, but climbed to number 6 on the charts after its appearance in the movie Midnight Cowboy in 1969. The tune also earned Nilsson his first Grammy Award. Another song from that album, One, would become a huge hit for the band, Three Dog Night.
Beep, 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 beep.
One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do.
I just let it keep, stay busy. And just wrote it on the phone while I was listening to this busy signal, you know.
It's the loneliest number since the number one.
What is the loneliest number?
During the late 60s, Nilsson also wrote Best Friend, the theme song for the television series The Courtship of Eddie's Father.
People let me tell you about my best friend. She's a warm-hearted person who loved me till the end.
In 1971, Nilsson wrote the soundtrack for an animated children's film, The Point, which spawned the hit single, Me and My Arrow. By 1971, Nilsson was living in the UK, where he recorded what would become his biggest commercial success, the Nilsson Schmilsson LP. That album included the number one single, Without You, a song written by British band Badfinger that showcased Nilsson's 3.5 octave range.
Oh, I can't forget this evening, or your face is your.
He would be rewarded with a second Grammy for his vocal performance. On a side note, Nilsson would later sell his London flat after Mama Cass Elliot died while staying there in 1974, followed by Keith Moon in 1978. Nilsson would continue to record during the mid-70s, putting out records that met with varying degrees of success, including 1974's Pussycats, produced by John Lennon.
Get yourself Harry Nilsson's new album, Pussycats, produced by John Lennon, Nilsson's latest Pussycats on RCA Records and Tapes. Meow and purr.
By the end of the decade, however, his output slowed considerably. In 1980, following the shooting death of John Lennon, Nilsson pursued other interests, such as television, and became an advocate for gun control in honor of Lennon.
And just then another guy, a kid, came running in the other side of the studio and he said, John Lennon's just been shot, he's dead. I went in the bathroom and just put a wet towel on my face and just said, Jesus Christ, not him.
He and his third wife, Una, spent their time raising 6 of his 7 children. In 1993, the hard-living Nilsson suffered a heart attack, which inspired him to begin writing and recording again. On June 15, 1994, while he was working on an anthology album and new material, Harry Nilsson's heart gave out. He was 52 years old.
And just found out that the wonderful, lovely, talented man who sang Everybody's Talking in that movie, Harry Nilsson, died today. And it would seem weird not to have an appropriate moment for him. He was a great artist.
He was buried in Prince Brothers Valley Oaks Memorial Park in Westlake Village, California.
You can't not have a good time when you're making a lot of money, you have some success, you have a beautiful wife and six kids. I had everything going for me except one thing, me, you know?
Although he feared being remembered solely as the drunkard who caroused with John Lennon, Nilsson, who may have lived the life of a devil, had the voice of an angel. Nilsson's success was achieved through his voice and songwriting skills alone, since he rarely, if ever, performed live and never toured. He infused songs that would otherwise have been considered schmaltzy or syrupy with raw emotion, giving them a deeper meaning and defying anyone to sing them better. Thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe and to like the video.